Welcome back. Joining us now from the Maryland SPCA is Katie Flory with a pet looking for a good home. Good morning, Katie.
Good morning.
And who did you bring with you this morning?
This is little Harley. He is a six-year-old Pug-Yorkie mix.
Oh my gosh, he is just so cute. Look
he
at
is.
Him, that little face. And he's so well behaved. Look
just
at him.
A little guy. I haven't heard a peep out of him all morning.
I know. He's just like, this is my TV time. I'm ready to shine. Someone take me home.
I think he's done this before.
Yeah, absolutely. Good. Okay, so he's going to help us through this segment here. You're talking about superfoods for
yes.
pets. It's all about the superfoods now
for
humans as well. But I'm surprised by some of these ingredients here.
And they're really neat because, first of all, they're great for people. We all know that. But some of these are also really great for your dog. Blueberries, for example. A lot of people are like, blueberries, but they're really a wonderfully fiber-rich fruit. They also are great for antioxidants.
Very interesting. Okay, but we were talking a little bit before the break that you don't want to give them a whole box of it.
No,
that might upset
their
stomach.
No, absolutely not. For a dog the size of Harley here, maybe two or three.
Okay.
A bigger dog, a few more. And I always recommend, you know, trying anything new with your dog, talk to your vet. Make sure they think, you know, it's also a good idea to do.
Good to know, especially what kind of medications they might be on and whatnot. Okay, now pumpkin.
Yes, it's really good for intestinal issues, and a lot of vets recommend having some on hand at all times, especially if your dog might have a sensitive stomach.
Interesting. You could probably freeze it into ice cubes.
That
might be good as well. I'm getting hungry here now, too. Okay, now, honey, this is interesting.
Yes, it is. You can use it for wound care. Now, we all know it tastes good, so I don't know that I would put it on a wound that the dog could get to, but a wound that they couldn't, it really can promote healing.
Oh, interesting. So that's more to put on top of them rather
yes.
than to eat.
Yes. Not okay. Well, and you could also give a little bit to eat, too. Probably less than a teaspoon,
okay.
But it really can be great to put on any type of wound that the animal might have, and it can help with healing.
Okay, now lastly, these are craisins, not
yes,
raisins,
not
and
raisins.
That's an important point.
Yeah, raisins you know, come from grapes, and those can be toxic to dogs, but cranberries, on the other hand, are not. They can really be good for urinary tract health. You can use dried cranberries are also fresh, although fresh cranberries we know can be really, really bitter, so the dog may not want to eat them.
And
so
how
the
many
craisins.
Of those?
Only a few as
okay.
well, and again, I recommend talking to your vet. Based on the size of your dog, they'll let you know how many.
Okay, very good, and Harley is looking for a home here.
Absolutely.
If you want to visit him at the Maryland SPCA, you can call the number on your screen, 410-235-8826, www.mdspca.org, and good to know that the superfoods good for us can be good for pets. Back to you guys.